Fred Roeder. I'm the managing director of the Consumer Choice Center. We're a global consumer group fighting as a grassroots organization to protect consumer choice. Today we're in Brussels, the capital of Europe, celebrating Brand Freedom Day. We decided to pick Brussels this year for the Brand Freedom Day because we see many initiatives in the member states, sometimes even in the cities of Europe, but also on European level, which advocate for infringement of brand freedom. These are advertisement bans, these are labeling restrictions. So putting warning signs on bottles of champagne, imagine you have a wedding party and half of your Nebukadnezar bottle of champagne says, drinking can cause impotence. Is this what you want to see on your wedding day? No. We have a great aesthetic relationship with brands. And we want to make sure that regulators and special interest groups are not going to destroy this fantastic aesthetic life experience we have with brands.
If you look after the consumer, then you encourage competition. When you encourage competition and when you encourage import and less taxation, the consumer gets a good deal because the product is cheaper.
We're standing in the middle of Brussels. All around us, on every side, are buildings filled with lobbyists. Some very good, very expensive lobbyists, all pushing for some special interest. Of course, because they're good lobbyists, they don't call it that. They don't say, let's raise barriers to entry and give my company a monopoly. What they say is, we need to protect the environment, or we need to protect workers' rights, or we need to ensure consumer safety. But it amounts to the same thing. And there is almost nobody, apart from maybe the Consumer Choice Center, making the opposite case.
We have members of parliament from almost all political groups who support our struggle for consumer choice and brand freedom. We work with policymakers and ask them to take a pledge for brand freedom so they stop new regulation that could be infringements on brand freedom.